Hello, I'm Bill Bright. I'm here with Dr. Ron Jensen, and we would like to invite you to join us in a special time of praising and worshiping our wonderful Lord.
That's why we're here today. It's to glorify the great, wonderful, powerful, majestic God of the universe. We want to praise Him and adore Him and tell Him we love Him for who He is, for His power and His majesty, for His grace, for His compassion, for His omnipresence, for being a caring, powerful, awesome God. And we want to praise Him particularly for His names and all that they entail, the majesty, the power, the position of the names of God. Now join us as we sing, Father, I love you, I praise you. Glorify thy name in all the earth. Jesus, I love you, I praise you, I adore you.
Jesus, I love you, I praise you, I adore you.
Glorify thy name.
Glorify thy name in all the earth. Glorify thy name.
There's something powerful about the names of God and the names of Jesus Christ. God's a great, powerful, majestic being, and He's manifested Himself through the Holy Spirit and through His Son, Jesus Christ. And He's given various names to Himself and to His Son that reflect their glory and power. And Scripture says, one day every knee shall bow and every tongue shall confess that Jesus Christ is Lord. There's a beautiful song that's been sung over the years that reflects the wonderful name of Jesus, Fairest Lord Jesus.
Fairest Lord Jesus,
Ruler of all nature,
Ruler of all nature,
O Thou of God,
O Thou of God,
and man the Son, Thee will I cherish.
Thee will I honor.
And beautiful Savior, Lord of the nations, Son of God,
and Son of Man,
glory and honor, praise, adoration, Emmanuel.
Emmanuel. Emmanuel.
His name is called Emmanuel.
His name is called Emmanuel.
God in us.
God in us.
Revealed in me. Think about those words. Emmanuel, Emmanuel, his name is called Emmanuel, and it means God in us, revealed in me. His name is called Emmanuel. How is God revealed in your life right now, right where you are, right in the midst of this praise? Is he revealed in joy and peace and love and power, or is he revealed in frustration, defeat, anger, bitterness, hurt? Whatever the situation may be with you, stop for a moment, reflect upon the God of the universe and how much he loves you. Think about the significance of that word Emmanuel. Think about how Jesus Christ is reflected in you, and take just a moment right now, right where you are, and pray and ask God to be revealed with you, through you in power and majesty and might. Emmanuel. God in us,
God in us,
revealed in me,
revealed in me, his name is called Emmanuel. Some
time ago, a dear friend of ours wrote a beautiful song that depicts the various names of Christ. And as we sing this through the first time, listen to the significant words that are reflective of Jesus Christ, and then join us again as we come back and sing that first verse over again. Morning Star.
Merciful Master, the Son of God, Reaper,
Merciful Master, the Son of God, Reaper, Redeemer, the Branch and the Rod, Ruler yet Servant, the Prince of Peace, Prophet, Physician, he's all of these. Jesus. Wisdom of God, Spirit, Foundation and Rock, Jesus, Jesus, Bright and Morning Star.
Messiah, the heir of all things, Alpha, Omega, the Lord and
Join us. Isn't he beautiful? Make it a prayer.
Isn't he beautiful?
Beautiful, isn't he?
Beautiful, isn't he?
Prince of Peace.
Prince of Peace.
Son of God.
Son of God.
Isn't he?
Isn't he?
Isn't he wonderful?
Isn't he wonderful?
Wonderful, isn't he?
Wonderful, isn't he?
Counselor.
Counselor.
Almighty God.
Almighty God.
Isn't he?
Isn't he? Isn't he? Isn't he?
Now a full-hearted prayer. Yes, he is.
Yes, you are.
Yes, you are.
Beautiful.
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 Yes, you are.
Yes, you are.
Prince of Peace.
Son of God. Yes, you are.
Yes, you are. Wonderful. He is beautiful, isn't he? And he's wonderful. He's majestic. He's Lord. He's Savior. He's ruler. He's King. And I don't know about you, but I want to just turn my eyes upon him when I think of his majesty. Join us as we turn our eyes upon Jesus. Again, a prayer of commitment. Turn your eyes. Jesus Christ, because he's so worthy. He's worthy of our praise. He's worthy of our lives. He's worthy of every part of us. He wants us all. A beautiful song entitled "The Lamb is Worthy" speaks of that great and wonderful worthiness of God. The Lamb is worthy.
To receive power
and the riches.
worthy to receive power and riches, wisdom, strength, honor, glory, blessing. In fact, Jesus Christ was worthy enough to be slain for you and for me. Another beautiful song says it another way, worthy. Music's playing in the background. Take a moment right now to tell the Lord how worthy He is. Tell Him how much you praise Him and praise Him. And then reflect on how much you love Him for who He is and for what He's done. Of the worthiness of God, what can we do but fall down before Him and say, Lord, I want You to have all of my life. I want You to have my thoughts and my actions. I want You to have my words. And you know, there's a beautiful psalm that's been put to music by a friend of ours that says, let the words of my mouth and the meditation of my heart be acceptable in Thy sight, O Lord. Let's sing it together. My words. But even more than that, he wants the very depths of us.
He wants us to open ourselves to Him and say, Lord, come in and have access to every area of my life. That's why the psalmist says in Psalm 139, Search me, O God, and know my anxious thoughts. Try me and know my ways, and see if there be any evil way in me, and lead me in the way everlasting. That's the kind of openness and transparency the Lord wants from us. There's a beautiful song that says, well, I will open it up. Think of these words.
And let you live in me.
I will open up my life to thee. And let's sing this back as a prayer of commitment. I will open up my heart to thee.
From His throne unto His own, His anthem raise.
is majestic, isn't he? And he's worthy of our praise and our adoration. He's worthy to be lifted up on high. He's worthy to be glorified. One of the reasons that's so true is that he's such a gracious and caring and loving God. And in fact, Jesus, our Lord's a wonder. We can't even understand him. There's a beautiful song that spells that out. It says, Jesus, what a wonder you are.
Jesus, what a wonder you are. You are so gentle, so pure and so
pray it back to him. Jesus, what a wonder you are.
Jesus, what a wonder you are.
You're so gentle.
You are so gentle.
So pure and so kind.
So pure and so kind.
You shine like a morning star. Jesus, what a wonder you are.
Jesus, what a wonder you are.
Jesus is not only a wonder, but he's our shield. Psalm 3:3 says, Thou, O Lord, art a shield about me. You're my glory. You're the lifter of my head. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. You're the lifter of my head. Join us, Thou, O Lord.
Yeah.
Again, make it a prayer. I can almost see your holiness.
I can almost see your holiness.
As I look around this place.
As I look around this place.
With my arms stretched out.
With my arms stretched out.
To receive your love.
To receive.
I can see you on each face.
I can see you on each face.
Spirit of God, lift me up.
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 Fill me again.
Fill me again with your love. Say, Spirit of God. Spirit of God.
Well, there are times when it doesn't seem that we see the holiness of Christ as we look around any place, or that we want to reach out our arms to receive His love, or see that love on each face. Because there are times when we're down, when we're frustrated, when we're defeated, and nothing seems to be working out. And that's when we need to remember Romans 8:28, that says, God causes all things to work together for good to those who love Him and are called according to His purpose. But He does it in His time. We need to remember that. It's in His time.
In His time. In His time. He makes all things beautiful. In His time. Lord, teaching me your way, that you do just what you say in your time.
Do you believe that? You ever feel like you're overwhelmed? Maybe depressed, maybe bitter, perhaps you're frustrated, maybe you're just down. Well, we all tend to have times like that. And you know, part of God's process for us is to go through those kinds of things that we can become usable vessels in His hand. Once I heard that God never uses a man greatly till He hurts him deeply. God just wants to break away the things from our lives that obstruct His power. Pray it back to the Lord and mean it in your time, in your time. You make all things beautiful in your time.
You make all things beautiful in your time.
Lord, my life to you I bring.
Lord, my life to you I bring.
Made song I have to sing.
Made song I have to sing.
Be to you a lovely thing. Again, pray it to the Lord. Beautiful.
Beautiful, beautiful. Jesus is beautiful. And Jesus makes beautiful things of my life. Carefully touching me. Causing my eyes to see. And Jesus makes beautiful.
One more time, beautiful.
Beautiful, beautiful. Jesus is beautiful, and Jesus makes beautiful.
You know, he really does, doesn't he? He does beautiful things in our lives, and he makes beautiful things of our lives. He's that kind of God. He's also a majestic God. He's a God of wonder. He's our shield. He's the Spirit that lifts us up. And he works all these things together beautifully in his time. But you know, the Lord's also our hiding place.
Come, let us worship and bow down. Let us kneel before the Lord our God, our Maker.
Come, let us worship and bow down.
Come, let us worship and bow down.
Let us kneel before the Lord our God.
Let us kneel before the Lord our God, our Maker.
For he is our God. And we are the people of his pasture.
And we are the people of his pasture.
And the sheep of his hand.
And the sheep of his hand.
And the sheep of his hand.
Just the sheep.
Again. Sing it back to the Lord. Come, let us worship.
Come, let us worship and bow down.
You know, as we've worshiped and adored and praised God today, what else can we do but glorify him? There's a song that says, I come to glorify you, identify with you, speak your name as my own. I come to crown you king. Your praises I sing, I choose to glorify your name.
I come to glorify you, identify with you, speak. I choose to glorify your name.
Again, as a prayer.
I come to glorify you, identify with you, speak your name as my own. I come to crown you king, your praises I sing. I choose to glorify your name.
Does that song express the desire of your heart? Crown you king, identify with you, glorify your name. You know, Matthew 6 says that if anyone would follow me, let him deny himself, take up his cross, and follow me. True commitment to Christ is identification with the person of Christ and his purposes. That's what God wants from you. Does he have it? If not, commit yourself again to the Lord as you sing the song again. I come to glorify you. Isn't God a great God? He's a God who builds into our lives love and joy and hope as we respond to his greatness. Join us as we sing, If You Want Love in Your Heart. Heart.
If you want joy in your heart,
joy that'll never depart.
Joy that'll never depart.
lift up his name.
And lift up his name.
And sing of his glory.
Sing of his glory.
Lift up his name.
Lift up his name.
And sing of his glory.
Sing of his glory. Just lift up his name. And sing of his glory and love. His glory and love.
And if you want hope in your heart.
If you want hope in your heart. Hope that'll never depart. Then lift up his name. And sing of his glory.
Really what worship's all about. Jesus said, I've come that you might have life and have it more abundantly. And that's what we want to see happen in your life. In a great measure, that happens as a result of worship and praise. For then we can delight and see that the Lord is good. Go on your way rejoicing. God bless you.
We encourage you to spend time every day praising and worshiping our Lord. Why should we praise God? Why should we take time out of our busy schedules to praise Him? First, because God alone is worthy of our praise. And second, we praise Him because of the benefits which come to us. As we praise God, our lives are transformed. He fills us with joy and peace, victory and power. No wonder the psalmist would exclaim, I will praise the Lord and call on all men everywhere to bless His holy name forever and forever. Praise the Lord. Yes, really praise Him. I will praise Him as long as I live. Yes, even with my dying breath. Hallelujah. Yes, praise the Lord. How good it is to sing His praises. How delightful and how right.